Well, thanks for the lift, Steve. We appreciated it. And you'll come to our rescue if we need you, won't you?
Of course.
Are you ready, sir?
Yes, let's go for it.
Let's go for the to the beginning.
Thanks very much, Steve. Cheers. Simon Geezer. Cheers.
Yeah. Cheers, Steve.
Cheers, Dan.
Bye.
Shalom, shalom.
We're walking to a reservoir in Oxfordshire, or North Oxfordshire, Warwickshire border, called Warmlington Reservoir. And it's the beginning of the D’Arcy Dalton Way, which is a 66-mile walk. This is a multi-day hike, lightweight backpacking. Ends in my neck of the woods, up on the Ridgeway, at a Neolithic long barrow burial chamber known as Waylands Smithy. So apparently it takes in some beautiful areas through rural countryside. Don't know where we're going to be camping tonight. It'll be interesting. It's the first time I've done a long distance hike with Joe, so should be good. Be good company. Hope you'll watch along. Well, this is Warmlington Reservoir. This is the actual start of the D’Arcy Dalton Way. There's Joe just getting himself some water. He forgot to pack his water. His bottles were empty. And there's our first waymarker, which goes over a canal via this bridge. We're on our way along the D’Arcy Dalton Way. I can't tell you much about it. All that I've learned about D’Arcy Dalton is that he was a man that worked for English heritage, I think, and he fought very hard to keep our footpaths open throughout the years. He's now passed away, and the walk was made to commemorate him. I know it'd be fun. Weather's looking to be very inclement at times, so it'd be a nice test of the camping equipment, and I love the sound of rain on the tent anyway. Just walked into Farnborough and we found a little place where they're offering homemade produce.
It's jam.
Lots of jam. That's a nice place, isn't it? We got a church behind us, but when we pan round, we look round. I don't know if this camera's picking it up, but there's all lumps and bumps and undulations in the field here. And it's quite possible this could be the remains of a medieval village.
Yeah.
What do you reckon?
Yeah, I reckon it might have been, yeah.
It could be, couldn't it?
Yeah.
He's a handsome chap, look. I haven't seen this breed of sheep before. Hello, how are you? You're a nice little pony. Anyway, our route has just taken us through a nice gentleman's garden there. And Joe says this is a Norman church. So he got a feeling he'll be getting his camera out. How can you tell it's a Norman church then?
Well, because Normans didn't build spires, they built ramparts.
Oh, okay.
So it's got ramparts over its Norman church. Plus, the actual length of it is in the shape of a Viking longhouse.
Right, okay, yeah.
That's a Norman church.
Okay, Norman church then.
Saxons built spires, Normans built ramparts.
Okay. Yeah, it's got a very squat tower. Yeah. Also, with our churches in the UK, we always get these ancient yew trees. Oh, very noisy road. We've been in earshot of this noisy road for the last half hour. It's the M40. There's a bridge which goes over it. The maps don't show it on the... Don't show the bridge on the maps, unfortunately. But perseverance paid off. Joe has an aversion to cattle. Anyway, the way is forward.
Shoo! You brazen piece of beef.
These are only young animals. I'll see you on my table on Sunday. Or maybe a few months' time. Being one of the lesser frequented walks, D’Arcy Dalton Way, I don't think many people have walked it. The path is quite indistinct. And this is it, look. That is the path ahead. I must say, the D’Arcy Dalton Way hasn't been a disappointment, Joe, has it?
No, it's been good, mate. Really, really nice. Really nice walking. Lovely rolling countryside.
Beautiful, yeah. Countryside.
Really good.
Really nice.
That's, of course, when we can find a way.
Yeah, it's not very well marked, is it? What does that look like in front then, Joe?
It's like a nice hostelry.
A hostelry?
Yeah.
Traditional beers and lagers.
Indeed.
Oh, what does that mean then?
Oh, I don't know. We might have to try it out, I think.
I reckon. Is it open? Lights are on in there.
Real. Come in,
where are we? We're going to go in.
I'm going in, only no celebration
for it.
Let's get in here.
Right. We're having a beer.
Oh, wow, it is.
A real ale. Yeah. Oh, it smells nice in here.
It does smell nice.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Nice wood burners.
Hello there.
Ooh.
What do you reckon for that then?
Hello!
What's it like, Joe?
Spot on.
That's a nice thatched cottage. They're restoring the roof on this one over here. Anyway, the pub was very nice, the beer went down beautifully, and we've got about 1.5 mile to go to find a camp. Well, we found a camp spot using Google Earth on our phones, and we're making our way there now. Yeah, my friend Simon, Riala Brand, he did a video once called Hollow Ways, and the sunken track like this. This is ancient, this has got to be very, very old, because, well, you can see how, by using Joe as a comparison, how steep the sides are. That's an old track. The D’Arcy Dalton Way, it follows a path, a track next to the woodland. We've come down the hill. It's now, as you can see, it's getting dark and it's 7:15. We're going to set up in this area. There's a stream over there, so Joe can get his water from there.
Let's try another one. Come on, there we are.
Well, it's still very early dawn. We've all decamped now. That's where we were. And spinning round, we'll look down the valley to what we woke up to see. There's the valley. We heard lots of owls last night. See Joe? Last time I saw him, he was walking down that way. He's vanished. There's a view looking back to our camping field last night. The first camp. Nestled in the distance is the village of Epwell. Tell us about this village, Andrew.
Apparently this village has been here for 1,000 years.
The village of Epwell.
Village of Epwell has been here for 1,000 years, yeah. And this is a sundial. And there's a nice little poem down here to read. And it says, Epwell 2000. This sundial marks 1,000 years of village joys and village tears, and as time passes, it will be forever here for all to see.
Yeah, it is a nice village.
Yeah, it's got an etched plan of the village there. Around the outside, you've got Roman numerals, 1 to 12.
In the distance there is a hill known as Yarn Hill. We think it might have been a hill fort years ago, but there's no sign saying it was. Well, so far, D’Arcy Dalton Way doesn't disappoint. We've walked through thousand-year-old villages, ancient churches, past a roundhouse which was built by primary school children, and through lovely countryside. It's been a fantastic walk so far. I'm really enjoying this walk. I don't know why more people don't do the D’Arcy Dalton Way, because it's not really it's not listed much on all the websites and the walking routes. Well worth it though, in my opinion. Here we are in Hook Norton, and that's Long Thatch over there. As you no doubt heard, behind me is the church. But you can't see what's in front of me until I turn the camera around. It's a Yankee Inn at SZ01. No doubt some of you are wondering what Yankee SZ01 is. It's a YouTube channel. He's a guy over in the States that he flies paramotors, but he also enjoys IPAs and real ales and that. So this is a Hook Norton beer. From the Hook Norton Brewery, which is about a mile away from here, and you can't get fresher than that. Cheers. Ah, very refreshing. What have we here?
Two more pints of beer. And dread the thought of any spillage, that's why I'm walking gingerly.
Have a pint with Sandy and Joe.
Hello, hello. Yeah. Yeah, can you hear the church?
Well, that was rather nice. We are now suitably inebriated, suitably refreshed, and we now continue on our journey. But it would have been a sin if we hadn't partook in the local ale, the Hook Norton beer, because it is brewed here, and it was a very nice pint as well, or two. Here's the Hook Norton allotment gardens, where the locals grow their veg. We now enter the churchyard at Greater Rollright.
Interesting thing about this church, because it's a mixture of Norman and Saxon, and the way you can tell, if you go up to the tower, obviously it's ramparts, but if you see the window, it's got the slight point on it, on the window. But Saxons, the way they built their windows was a bit of a curve with a slight point, which is the way you tell a Saxon church from a Norman church.
So that's a Saxon church then?
That's a Saxon main building, it's a Norman tower.
The Norman tower?
Yeah.
What do you do that for? We just found a little spindleberry tree. I think they're poisonous. Joe's taking a photograph. Just entering Salford Church now. It's got a different type of spire. A tower and a higher pitched roof to it. Way takes us through yet another church. It seems to be this is a bit smaller, a chapel of sorts. We're near past Salford and near Churchill. I got it wrong earlier, I said Churchill. It's Cromwell. Cromwell, apparently. There's a manor house just across the way. That's Cromwell Manor over there. Apparently I got it wrong again. It's not Cromwell, it's Cornwell.
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 Cornwell, yeah.
Not Cornwall. No. Our path ahead, you can just make out where the path is, because now the crop's been harvested, you can see the green track. Where it used to be. But the going, it's not always been an easy route to follow. It's been well signposted in places, in other places not so good, has it, Joe?
No, not at all. No.
But you're using an app, you're using
I use OS Ordnance Survey Map Finder. You can get it on the Google Play or the iPhone Play Store. It's free to download, but what you do is you pay for certain grids throughout the country. Say if you wanted SP11, for instance, you pay $1.99 and that gets downloaded straight to your phone and you've got it forever. And 1 in 25,000 scale is $1.99, or you can have Land Ranger, which is 1 in 50,000 scale, which is 69p, but I personally prefer to work off 1 in 25,000 scale.
Yeah, that's a good scale.
Yeah, it's done as well because, you know, we've managed to find our way through some really difficult parts of this route by using it.
Yeah. Well, end of day two now. We've done 20 mile today. Yesterday was, how far did we walk yesterday?
12,
so that's puts us at 32 mile, approximately halfway now, approaching some woodland, and that's where we're going to be setting up camp tonight, somewhere in these woods. It's just starting to rain, so the tents are pitched now, just in time. It's just starting to rain, as I say, it's just getting dark. We're on a bit of a slope, but we should be okay here. Not a bit well for beating track. Pitched close together, both Lansham ones. In the gloaming, you can just see the stove just primed now. That's the clickstand stove with the Trangia burner. Boiling the water from the meal. And Joe's got himself a new stove.
Yeah. This is called the Trangia Mini. So what you get is what you see there with the Trangia in it. Plus also, you get sort of like a 750ml pot. And you get a non-stick frying pan. And you also get, obviously, the Trangia. And you get the pot grabbers as well. And a good thing about these pot grabbers, got a straight bit and a bent bit. So the straight bit goes underneath the pot and then grab the pot and it's easy to maneuver around.
You're well pleased with that.
And if you look on the bottom underneath there, I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but there's a ridge there underneath the pan that is designed to sit perfectly on this here. So you put it in and as you see, that's locked into place and it ain't going anywhere.
Morning of day three. Slept rather well last night. We did have a lot of rain. Oh, and a bit of wind. And the stove ain't gonna light that way. I'll have to use a piece of woodland debris to get it going. This will work first time. Mm.
There we go. Lit.
That's the stove lit. Time for the first coffee of the day.
Bang on 7 o'clock in the morning there. That's the tents just before they're taken down. This is the start of day three. A lot of rain last night. We're going to try and do another 20 mile. We've done 21 mile yesterday. And we're going to try for the same again today.
Well, there's Joe packing up, and you can see a dry patch and a dry patch. That's where we were camped. We had a lot of rain last night.
We're in a place called Churchill. We just camped outside of it about a mile away. And we've come across a memorial to a geologist that was born here, William Smith, father of British geology. Apparently he was born here. Again in Churchill we have this wonderful fountain. That used to be one of the main sources of water for the villagers apparently.